Welcome back to more Trails in the Sky, first chapter. In the last episode, we had a bunch of story stuff dumped on us involving a blackout with using the Black Orbent and all that. In this episode, I went ahead and took the liberty of getting us up to the fifth floor of the operations room like we were talking about last episode, so here we go. Let's just get into this. Try not to dilly-dally too much. We can stuff as much as we can in this episode. Hello! We're here looking for, what is it, a combustion engine and some gasoline? Yeah, we're here, yeah. Actually, yeah, we're with the Professor Guild. We probably should mention that first. Yeah, we're here, Professor, the request of Professor Russell. No, we're just, again? You really don't have much faith in him, do you? We're just here to pick up something for him. Capel unit? What's that? Yeah, we're looking for, like I said, a combustion engine, I think it was. Oh, this is the Capel. Okay, gotcha. So basically, it's a really, really fast computer. Sounds like it. Sounds fancy. No sweat. I would put it that in that way, Joshua. Okay, so I lied. All that stuff went completely over my head. Should be simple enough, right? Can it be? How hard can it really be? Famous last words. All right, we're looking for, let's see, universal tech, I think. Maybe. Let's just see what it says. Before you ask, no, I'm not reading all this. If you want to read it all, just pause the video. See, related talk. Here we go. This is what I'm looking for. Usable energy by burning fuel. Less efficient. Okay, Maintenance Chief Gustav owns that. Okay, gasoline. Fuels combustion engines. 20 mid-sized tanks. And then orbit manufacturing factory. Gotcha, okay. Haulage vehicle. Let's look at this while we're in here, too. I guess. Might as well. Use for transporting cargo. Underground factory engines. Okay. So, looking for Chief Gustav, and then go down to the bottom. Alright. Like a magic box or something. I thought a magic box was a TV, not a computer. Then again, I guess they're both boxes, and I guess advanced technology would seem like magic to anybody, to some people who could understand it. Airfield, okay. I'm assuming by that he means a landing port. Manufacturing in the basement, yeah, gotcha. Alright. Let's go. Down the stairs, which I've been taking all the time. Like, between episodes, I literally just ran up the staircase. I didn't really see the much points in keeping that on camera. I just took the liberty of cutting up there. Because why not? Alrighty. Manufacturing should be down here. Hello! Hello! We need some gasoline, please. Ending. Ooh, fancy conveyor belt. That's pretty nice. Is that going to be enough for what we need? Then again, we're only going to be powering using it to cut the orbit open, so we shouldn't need that much. Assuming the combustion isn't just a gas guzzler like a lot of cars nowadays. Oh, It's a gigantic pain. Wow. I butchered that word. Like, I don't even know how. It's like a dyslexia, like a gigantic instead of a gigantic. Like, how did I even, how? English. Wow. All right, let's see. We need to go to, he's at the airfield. And you know what, actually, real quick, I want to check. Here, this is the Orbit shop here. I don't know if I mentioned that before. Let's see, there's, ooh, HP 2, HP 3. I haven't seen a 3 before. Let me look at our Orbit and see what we got. Let's see, defense 1, attack 2. There's a defense 2 we could get. Let me check our stats real quick. Okay, yeah, let's see, defense 2, we could give us both defense 2. Cast 2, EP cut 2, do we have that, or, no, we do not have an EP cut anywhere for anyone, so, but then again, considering that both Estelle and Joshua are more strength-based and not really arts-based, it shouldn't be too big of a deal, so let's, yeah, how about we just synthesize 2 defense 2s for now, oops, and let's see, defense 1, defense 2, and then defense 2, perfect, alright, and we'll save those defense 1s for later, they might come in handy, who knows, worst case we can sell them for money later, let's see, looking for maintenance chief Gustav, I believe his name is, hello! You are not who I'm looking for. This is what they meant by airfield, right? Let's see. Pretty sure, but I don't see him. Hello, do you know where Gustav is? Of course he's not here. We just kind of looked around and didn't see him. Lyson Fortress, huh? Great. Wonderful. He won't be coming back from there anytime soon. Do we have to... We probably have to end up going all the way up there, probably. Unless there's some way we can get, like, a message to him or something. Then again, there is an airship coming in. How convenient would it be if the maintenance chief was on this airship and was getting off right now? That would just be so convenient. Probably too convenient, though. I highly doubt he's gonna be there. Hold the phone. Since when were public airships orange? Because it's not public. That's why. The Leibniz. Like Leibniz notation? Interesting. That's like the one thing I remember about my calculus class. Oh. I guess he is there. Well. How convenient is that? Let's see. Hello! Looking for Gustav, please. Oh, you're him. Okay, that's great. Guess he's got one on hand. I guess so. It's a heavy beast though, so be careful. This invisible combustion engine is so heavy. That is quite a coincidence. is also the coincidence of you being here. Research, huh? So many coincidences. I wonder if Joshua was thinking about that, the same thing. Alright, back to the professor. I'll probably just cut away and see you guys there. BRB. We're back. Excellent. I can't help but hear it. Whenever I hear the word excellent just by itself, I can't help but hear it in the Team Fortress 2 Spies voice. I can't help it. It's just excellent. I know that's a terrible accent. It sounds nothing like that, but if you guys have played TF2, you know what I mean. It does make a racket, wow. It's so loud, it's making the text boxes shake up and down. That is a lot of sparks. I hope those barrels don't have gasoline in them or anything. Or anything else explosive. A tiny scratch. All that for a tiny scratch. Wow. Can go through quite a few saw blades. Definitely gonna be quite an interesting idea. Uh-oh, here comes the chief again. Surprised he didn't come in yelling at the professor for the loud noise the saw was making. Uh-oh. I think we can handle that. You think what I'm thinking, Joshua? You tell him, Joshua. Kids shouldn't sweat the details so much. Alrighty, here we go. And this is the reason why when we went down to the hot springs earlier for that quest, why I didn't deal with all those monster chests that were down there, because we'll be heading down that way now. Oh, hello, person. I don't think I saw you before. But yeah, that's why I didn't do that. Hello, cutscene. Yeah, we went there just like last episode. Not last episode, but two episodes ago. Alrighty. Actually, hold on. You. What do you sell? Do you sell food? Okay, you sell stuff. Okay. Flowers. What about you, Mr. Drinks? Okay. We don't have any of this. Or this. And, or this. Alright, just buy some stuff so we can learn the recipes for them. Plus, we'll have healing items, so it'll be very convenient. Before we go, though, let's check the Bracer Guild and make sure there's not even more side quests. Ooh, there is. There's a whole crap ton of them. Okay. Let's see. Product testing. Lab. Okay. And then Trap Plains Road. And then, let's see. Fourth floor on the clinic. Okay. Definitely want to take care of the short-term ones now. So, the rest of this episode will probably be dealing with these rest of these side quests. So, just heads up. Alright, haulage. I want to do the, okay, fourth floor, that, and then fourth floor clinic. Okay. Alright, let's deal with those two. Because it seems like those two can be dealt with pretty easily. So, up to the fourth floor! Alright, here's the lab, which is probably where the sneakers are. Hello! Yeah, we're here about a side quest involving sneakers. Yeah, sure, we have some time. Alpha Strega. Just a second there, buddy. Just say the Strega Corporation? I think he did. Here goes Estelle geeking out over shoes again. Don't mind her. She's still something of a sneaker collector. She pretty much adores the Strega brand ones. Sneaker-mania. That's one term for it. Estelle, would you snap out of it? I get that you're excited, but we still have work to do. Oh, yes, you're right. Scary amount of spirit, huh? Yes, absolutely! Oh, man. Quite a long ways. All right. Just wear the shoes, see if we can wear them out. Gotcha. All right. So let's equip these. And Estelle loves these shoes, so how can we can't not? Well, this is made for Estelle, so I doubt any of the others could actually wear them. So let's go with these, even though I think there's a little bit of a defense decrease, it's kind of hard to say. Yeah, we lose about 11 defense, or no, 10 defense, okay, gotcha. Shouldn't be too bad though. Hello! Introductions ahoy! Yeah, sure, we can do it. No problem. Cigarette? Why would you have cigarettes in a clinic? Exactly, Estelle, exactly! Having a smoking man in the factory definitely makes sense, considering all the flammable, the explosive stuff around, probably. Like the gas. Alright, Travis from Operations. Hugo, Design Room. Okay. In the first floor lobby. That might help. An eyewitness to what? Yeah, that might be a lead. The cat? Really? I guess that's why she said, I don't know how much help it'll be. That you did. I guess it's worth a shot. Fresh milk, huh? I think we just used our last batch at cooking the other stuff, so we'll have to go get some more. Excuse me. Let's see. I guess we have to go. Let's go talk to the guys. The Travis and was this guy Travis over here? Yeah. Oh no, that's Terry. Excuse me. Travis is. This is fourth floor. So what does it say? Let's see. Travis on 1F. Okay. I guess we'll talk to them real quick and then we'll run over to the store, buy some more fresh milk. And hopefully should be okay. This is not Travis. This is Dodge. I don't care about you. Hello. You are not either person that I'm curious about. You are someone I'm curious about. Sorry, I was kind of skipping through this text a little bit. Come on, you, do you have anything? Yeah. We already talked, so let's ask. You been smoking lately? How rude. Then again, asking that out directly probably isn't the best idea. So, you are not Travis. It does say, operations, okay, so we probably should go ahead, since we're down here, might as well go to the store, go buy some milk from the store, though. Pretty sure we used up all of it making the coffee ice cream earlier. So let's see, fresh milk. Here we go. Hello, kid. Okay. Whatever you say, kid. This is not the right way. Let's see, operations. What floor was that on? Was that floor 3, was it? I don't remember. I want to say it was floor number 3. But I'll have to check. Because I know the lab was on floor number 3, which is where Professor Russell is. Or, excuse me, workshop. Design room. No. Let me see. Let me go down one more. Let me go down to the second floor and see if it's down there. And if not, we'll go up to the 5th floor and check there. Office. Archives. No. Let's use the elevator since we're over here. 5th floor. See, this does not have a label on it. Oh, because it goes outside. Okay, gotcha. That would explain why it doesn't have a label. Ah, here we go. Operations. Perfect. Hello, Travis. You've been smoking lately? Doesn't necessarily mean he isn't the culprit, though. I mean, I guess that is true. We can't. He does seem pretty open to us searching the room and everything. So I guess it doesn't seem like he would do it. But I guess innocent until proven guilty, I guess, is the mindset there. So let's see. Lab. We went to the lab clinic. Here we go. Antoine! Have some milk, Antoine. Have some nummy milk. Alright, let's see. Let's take the cat with us. Travis is closer, so we'll go back up and talk to him with the cat, see what Antoine has to say about Travis. Just in case, since he's closer. I guess he isn't. Either that or Antoine is not reliable. One of the two. But let's go downstairs and talk to Hugo and see. We'll see if Antoine has a reaction to Hugo. Let's see. Wait a second. It was. Yeah, first floor, right. Over here. Hello, Hugo. I sicked our cat on you. Nope. Somewhere in where? Okay. I guess we'll just talk to people. Right, you were just talking about the telephone book catalog thing. Yeah, we'll be going there probably next episode. Because this episode will probably be dealing with the side quests. I might make this episode go kind of long since it has to deal with side quests. So that way the next episode we can just get started on story stuff. While we're down here, let's go talk to Faye here. I mean, I doubt that she would have... I'm assuming it's a she since they got purple hair and Faye is a girl. It seems like a girly name, but anyways... talk to her, I guess, but she doesn't have any reaction out of Antoine, so let us just go talk to people through the factory, I guess. I suppose I could cut away, or not, because we just found it. Antoine's reacting to the door. Isn't this Murdoch's office? Hello, Murdoch. You have something you're hiding from us. I think you do. Seems to be a little bit on edge. Let's see. You have anything else to say? Nope. Let's see. Alright. He's probably keeping him locked up in his room. Oop, there's a key. We're gonna break into your room. Sorry about this. We need to find these cigarettes. There they are! I sure hope you have a good explanation for this. Uh-huh, sure. Just one quick puff, huh? I guess it's understandable, but still, that's no excuse for doing it. The break sounds good. At least she seems willing to forgive and forget, as she said. At least he seems apologetic, so water under the bridge. Alright. Got that settled. He just phases through the door, and the door doesn't even open. Funny. I think it's more than half the credit, honestly. We wouldn't have found it without him. Alrighty, quest complete. Let's see, what else? Oh, so we had to deal with. We did this when we have to go a bunch around. So let's do that, and then let's see, Forgeal Bar, powerful ingredients. Okay. I guess we'll just have to see if we have anything appropriate on hand. And then this haulage vehicle. Okay, search Trat Plains Road. Alright. And then Ritter Road Monster. Gotcha. Alright. So I guess I will meet you guys down at the Forgeal Bar, I guess? Maybe? Actually, it's not that far, so I'll just... we haven't been there either, so I'll just walk it. I'll just hoof it. Alright. Almost went down the wrong side. Let's see. Forgeal Bar. Hello, where are you? You are not the bar. Here we go. You're looking for... what's his name? Ben? Yes. This is not Ben. You are Ray. I don't really care what you have to say, you're not Ben. Here we go. Talk to you. Let's see. Anything interesting we got? Aw. What? That's too bad. You don't even tell us what. Oh, come on, dude. Come on, what do you have to sell? Rotini pasta. I'll grab some of this. And this. And this. Just buy one of each of these. I guess we'll just have to find something. Hopefully, like maybe when we go to this to kill this Ritter Road monster, maybe he'll drop something that'll be interesting. Or let's see. Or when we go to search the Trat Plains Road for. The Trat Plains is down south. Okay, gotcha. That's actually towards Elmo Village. So how about we go take care of the Ritter Road monster first? Let's save real quick. Right there. Alright. Ritter Roadway. Let's see if we can find this monster. It is called the... some kind of viper? Mercury Viper. Gotcha. Alright. Let us see. Have we been down this road before? I don't think so. Oh yeah, we went down. I've went down this road off camera, kind of, when we went to go to Sanctum Gate. So hello, you are probably it. Yes, hello. All right, let's see. Does the thing say anything? No, it doesn't say anything. So I guess. Hold on. Before we do that though, I want to check and make sure it's a snake. So obviously it's gonna hit us with poison. So, come on, game, seriously, quit bugging out. Thank you. Poison, there we go, poison. And then Tita, also blind, yes, all right. Let's save again, so I don't have to redo that in case we have to redo the fight. And let's go. All right, here we go. They are weak to wind and fire. And that guy is really weak to wind and fire. And Joshua has the strongest arts, but let's see how much physical does. Pretty decent, actually. So yeah, they're using venom, which obviously would poison, but we all have poison resistance, so no big dealio. That guy kind of hurts, though. They're all beating up on Joshua. Jeez. Let's hit this guy. That way, Tita can hopefully get three guys in one shot. No, we can't get three, but she can get two, at least. Which is nice. Kaboom! And of course it missed the one she was targeting. Yikes. Can heal up Joshua the next chance we get. Alright, Joshua, let's see. Strength up. See if you can kill this guy. There we go. And then Estelle, let's see if you can tear up Joshua so we don't die. Go, that at least heals him up a little bit. Oh gosh, Tita. I'm gonna go ahead and show off Tita's craft. That way we don't lose it. Let's see. Who should I use it on? I'll use it on... See, that guy's almost dead versus that guy, so let's use it right here. So yeah, that's pretty awesome, if I do say so myself. Huge area of effect. Alright, Joshua, how about you use your, yeah, just use your freaking sever on that guy. Make use of that critical. Might as well. And it didn't even kill him, wow. Got him knocked down pretty hard, though. And rip Tita. Right. I knew I should have healed her. Alright, Estelle, can you possibly... kill this guy? Maybe. Yes. Okay, good. And once we get down to, like, one guy, then I'll deal with... Then I'll revive Tita. Get her back. Oof. Estelle's low. I definitely don't want her to die. Considering how low... How... Energy shots are craft charged up, so let's use one of these. That way we can learn some recipes. And that's one of the reasons why we bought the items in the first place, is to eat them and learn the recipes. So, still, can you? I don't think you can kill this guy, but try, yeah, just whack him. And then, Joshua, you can kill this guy. Estelle's low, though. I really wanted to heal up Tita right now, but I can't really do that. What else can we use? Rainbow jelly beans. Yeah, let's use up some of these rainbow jelly beans, since those are pretty easy to get. Pretty easy to... I can buy the materials at the store, I think, mostly. Alright, let's see. Do I want to... Yeah, let's knock down this guy a little bit more. And then we'll heal up Tita later. Like, we'll heal her up now. Let's use up one of the potlucks on a shell.
We're good to go.
Since it's not really in huge danger right now. And then Joshua, can you heal? Yes, you can heal her at least. Do that. Just want to make sure she gets the experience, because she's... The one thing about Tita is she has low HP, so she's not terribly useful. She's kind of a glass cannon, if you'll pardon the pun. So it's kind of, you have to be really careful with her. It's like 39 damage. So her main appeal is just the fact that she can, her attack has a wide area of effect, but her strength itself is not very high. So she's really more of a situational, gimmicky kind of character. Let's see, I don't think it dropped anything, unfortunately, so we're gonna have to not deal with that. I was kinda hoping he would drop the interesting thing we'd need for that one side quest, but then again, I guess not. Can't have everything, so... This episode is getting kind of long, so I think what I'll do is I'm gonna head back to the Bracer Guild and report these quests, and then next time on Trails in the Sky First Chapter, we will continue with these side quests. Deal with them, and then head down to the hot springs. Hopefully, we can deal with them next time and do all that in the episode there. So, all right. So, I will see you guys next time. Bye bye. Thank you for watching.